How do we explore the ocean bottom?
The ocean floor is a vast and mostly unexplored part of our world. But today, we have lots of tools we can use to try and understand it. From crewed HOVs, remote-controlled ROVs, and even to fully independent AUVs.
So, what was the first submarine?
The first known submarine was built in 1620 by Dutch inventor Cornelius Drebbel and dove in the River Thames to a depth of 15 feet. It was made of wood and leather and required oars to move. In 1776, during the American Revolution, the Turtle became the first military submersible when it attempted to sink the HMS Eagle. It was operated by pedals and is the first known use of a propeller on a watercraft. Over the next 200 years, underwater technology got better and more practical. This paved the way for exploration and pushed people further and further into the depths. In 1960, Jacques Picard and Don Walsh used the Bathyscay Trieste to dive 11,000 meters to the Challenger Deep, the deepest part of the ocean in the Mariana Trench. The trip down took almost 5 hours, and the Trieste experienced 1,000 times the pressure than at the surface, at almost 16,000 psi, the equivalent weight of 4 cars per square inch. To survive the extreme pressure, the crew were huddled into a small steel sphere with thick walls. The shape helps evenly distribute the load and reduces the risk of being crushed. This design principle is used on many HOVs, such as DSV-3 Turtle or Deep Sea Challenger. But sometimes it's too dangerous or expensive to have people explore the bottom. That's where ROVs come in. These are controlled from a mothership via a tether and are like a real-life video game. When even more flexibility is needed, explorers use AUVs. These robots are programmed to operate independently for long periods of time and are great for mapping the ocean floor. So now you know.